If you was trying to settle down, get a fact. So I'm pull up in the city with a nice jump. Lights up, lights on. Chinese throw the chicken, need a wipe to throw the rice on. Pull up double park with all the ice on. Pick them like, she run it up, she run it up. She pay her bills, she f*** it up. 50 Second Street, I double down, then I double up. 2023 and I'm the only coming up, yeah.
Can't stop till we all up.
Used to have a silver tooth and I was just a pup, yeah. Now I got some killers who got shotties with the pumps. I don't wanna catch the feelings.
Bring your lunch pails, fellas. I need to see that workman attitude today. We gotta get better today. What I wanna know is, who's ready to get better? I'm ready to work today. You ready to work? You ready to work? All right, then let's see it. Let's get out there and do it.
Ready, ready. Check out.
Hey man, that was great. I mean, you had a great day today. You're taking the first steps towards success in this league. But don't fall back and get lazy. There's more steps ahead, so you gotta keep it up.
Club selling out a hitter doing stadiums. Gold diggers don't come around, they don't survive my radius. I keep it too real for real, and that's that made me rich. That's what made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich.
And whole club selling out a hitter doing stadiums. Small business don't come around, they don't survive my radius. All I talk about, and that's what really made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich. That's what made me rich. The whole club. White to be shooting in the eyes. I'm sleeping good at night. See the door don't got no locks.
It's the NFL on EA Sports, and we've got the Chargers' creative quarterback. After his last game, he's now across 3,000 yards for the season. It's the Chargers and the Lions just ahead on EA Sports.
From the second largest city in the U.S., Los Angeles, California, we've got football as EA Sports coverage of the NFL is on the air. Today we hit double digits, week 10, and we've got a good one in store as it'll be the Detroit Lions taking on the L.A. Chargers. Hi, everybody. Brandon Gordon alongside Charles Davis. And, Charles, we take a look at this Charger club entering play here. They're halfway home, looking good at a perfect 8-0.
And not much to complain about so far, is there? I'd have to say they're the best team in the NFL through the first half of the year.
Meanwhile, for the Lions here, they're in a real groove of late. Winners of 5 of their last 6 games. The shadow's starting to get a bit longer. Week 10 of the NFL season is here, and we're underway on EA Sports. Here's Darius Davis on the return, and he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further. So here's the Charger offense making their way out. And trotting out there, a guy who's established himself as a veteran in this league, now in his 5th year at quarterback.
And he's had such a sensational season to this point, leading the NFL in passing yards. He's been helped out a lot by an outstanding set of receivers, and he's quick to give them credit. But I think even they would tell you that he's the guy that makes this offense go.
Here's Eckler to begin the drive. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. just like that, it's a gain of 12 and a first down on their first play.
Partner, is that what you call a quick hitter? That was actually a bolt of lightning, wasn't it? Right out of the gate.
And, of course, on the heels of him winning AFC Offensive Player of the Week 1 week ago. Found a little room there as he's up to about the 37. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
So, CD, you look at this offense and what they've been able to do. 8-0, perfect through the first 2 months of the year. Second half of the season still to come. We get that. But what kind of a percentage chance do you think that they have of running the table?
Partner, I think it's hard to say because history would tell us that the chances aren't good at all. We've seen a lot of good teams get to this point, and then they have that one bad week and takes them out of the running. I'm going to say 25%, and I feel like I'm being generous with that number.
Back to throw now on first down, eluding the pressure right. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with second and a yard. Eckler now between the tackles. And they eventually get to him at the 17 after a pickup of 17 into the red zone. First down. Quite the opening drive march there.
It looks a lot like what we saw in practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script, you go through your play calling, you go through all the stuff and establish things, and it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
They go play action here on first down. Touchdown! Gerald Everett with his 16th touchdown of the year. And the Chargers get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator?
Oh,
remember
yeah.
What he told us?
Absolutely.
With some teams, I script to probe in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and continue that in this one.
Extra point up and good by Dicker. And it's now a 7-0 game. Here's Dicker now as he'll send this one away. And it'll come out to the 25 as Raymond will elect not to bring it out. For the Lions offense, getting ready to go to work here. And under center, a man whose career has been rejuvenated a bit as of late. And season number 8 now out of Cal, it's Jared Goff.
And you've got to think that they've got to be feeling pretty fresh. You know, coming off of the open week, didn't have to play, right? Gives them a chance to rest up a little bit, heal some of those aches and pains, and excited about playing again. That really rekindles things a little bit. I want to see how they come out and establish themselves here early.
And that bye week coming right where they want it, in the middle of the schedule. They'll come up now 2nd and 4 from the 31. First run of the game for Jahmyr Gibbs, the Alabama product. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. A loss on that play, and now 3rd down gets tougher, 3rd and 6. When you talk about the defense for these Chargers, it's a unit that has had all sorts of issues against the pass, dead last in the NFL, number 32 in the league.
Take those rankings, throw them right out the window, because this is what you prepare for, this is what you practice for, this is what you think about. The ultimate test, taking out the
Chargers, able to get the pressure and bring him down.
Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
He is proving his worth defensively, getting the sack here. That comes after being named the AFC Defensive Player of the Week for his performance in last week's game.
He's stacking games together, isn't he? I mean, you just mentioned what he did the previous week to be named AFC Defensive Player of the Week, continuing to play at that level. And when you get that kind of confidence going, those kind of guys are hard to stop.
Jack Fox out to punt here on 4th down. Keenan Allen back deep for the Chargers. Fair catch called for and made at about the 32-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt. And it'll be Charger football here as they take over. The Charger drive about to get going.
And they, as mentioned, unbeaten to this point in the year. But you think this game their toughest test yet.
I absolutely do, because to me, this is a good measuring stick game because they've been able to take advantage of the schedule. But here, this is another team leading its division with an eye on making a Super Bowl run, so this game is crucial.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. And he overshot him there. It's out of bounds, incomplete.
Well, they approached this drive with a lot of confidence after their last one ended up as a touchdown. But incompletions on their first two throws has them huddling up and trying to figure out a big play here on third down to get their momentum going again.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Flushed out right. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. A big one there on third down. They hit for 30 yards.
No surprise to see him running again here is something he's done throughout this season. And that run puts him over 500 yards on the ground for the year. He's got to be thinking to himself, if I'm already at 500, what's to stop me from going for 1,000?
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. On play action, they'll throw. This caught left side by the tight end Parham. A well-executed 22-yard gain.
Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass on the first drive and comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
Throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw when they went through two-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations. Ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one.
Second and 9 now. And it's caught. And he's brought down. Coming into the week, he's the NFL's leader in receiving yards. There's his first catch, and it's good for a first down.
I think he has to be saying to himself, how did that not wind up a touchdown? Remember, he just did the tip of the ball across the plane. It's not going to get there, but they're going to be set up in great shape with first and goal.
Eckler will take this into the end zone for a Charger touchdown.
Sometimes offense, if you get too cute down near the goal line, but there's nothing fancy about this one. As Coach Lombardi would say, we get a seal here, and we get a seal here, and we run this play in the alley. And that's good work to hit the hole hard and finish in the end zone.
Dicker down to tack on the extra point. And it's good, and they have jumped out here to a quick 14-0 first quarter lead. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told. And it's Austin Eckler who finishes things off with a touchdown run. This fielded right at the goal line. And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. Back onto the field come the Lions for their second overall drive. They were winners the last time they took the field, which was 2 weeks ago. They had the open week last week, so this is a squad that should be really refreshed and ready to roll.
I would agree, because when you get that open week after a victory, it does wonders for everyone. Obviously, your body.
And now the rookie's free. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. 34 yards there at a first down. What we saw there, that's what we know that he can do. He can break tackles and turn them into big runs, and that's what he did.
And what is the buzz phrase nowadays in football for a guy like that? Contact balance. The ability to go through trash, come out the other side, avoid and run through contact, and keep your balance.
Well, they'll run it here on the jet sweep. And he's going to be met at about the 43. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8. But you talk about the defense for these Chargers. They really played well a week ago in that win over the Jets.
And what I saw on film was nearly an unstoppable pass rush. They had 5 sacks last week, plenty of hurries. So now do you just max protect on offense, keep everyone in and run, you know, 1 or 2 receiver routes to make sure your quarterback stays up? We'll soon find out.
It's a gain of 6, moves him to a manageable 3rd and 2 situation.
Well, this defense for the Chargers, they really played well a week ago in that win over the Jets.
And what I saw on film was a nearly unstoppable pass rush. 5 sacks last week, plenty of hurries given up. So now what do you do on offense? You just max protect, keep everyone in and run the ball? Or maybe just 1 or 2 receiver routes in order to try and keep your quarterback upright?
That's about what you would expect since they're so efficient on picking up 3rd downs in the top 5 in the NFL. It's all a mindset, and I guarantee you, it started in the offseason. 3rd down's important to them. They find a way to pick them up at a very good clip.
On 1st down, gone. A throw left sideline falls incomplete.
So it looks like they still have some fight in them on this series because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But this defense gets 2 more stops. They can keep them out of that area.
Here's 2nd and 10. Back to throw, Goff. They'll find his rookie tight end, Sam Laporta. And they eventually get to him at the 17 after a pickup of 17 into the red zone, 1st down.
You can almost hear the sigh of relief coming from their sideline and from their point on the field because this has been a tough start for them thus far. A much-needed 1st down there. They needed something good to happen. Plays like that will continue to help them dig out of this hole.
Now a throw to the end zone on 1st down, but it winds up incomplete.
Brandon, watching their tape from last week, I saw plenty of plays like we just saw there, forcing incompletions. It was key in their win last week. They're hoping the same thing happens this time out, too.
Goff. Yeah, he's got it. And in for the Lions touchdown. Jameson Williams. From 17 yards out. And the Lions have got it back to within a score.
As the offense went on the field to start their last drive, you know they discussed in the huddle, hey, if we put one in the end zone here, we've put ourselves in a position to start making a comeback.
Riley Patterson now for the extra point. And that one makes it 14-7. So that drive in total, 8 plays. And it was Jameson Williams wrapping things up with a touchdown. And Patterson back out there to send this one away. And Davis content just to bring this out to the 25-yard line. So here are the Chargers to take over. They've gone 2 months without a loss, 8 straight wins for them. And they've got the lead here in this one as well, trying to make it 9 in a row. Now a play fake here on 1st down. Looking left side and it's complete. Touchdown, LA! Chargers are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Boy, Charles, this offense is just so explosive. They lead the league in scoring, and another example of just how good they are right there on that play.
Yeah, we often overstate about how explosive teams are, but this team is truly a threat to score on every snap, especially on the first few plays of any series. And a big strike like that, that only adds to their reputation as the league's best offense.
Extra point up and good by Dicker. And it's now 21-7. One of the shortest drives you'll ever see. 1 play, 75 yards, 6 points. Now after the Dicker field goal, he's back out ready to send it away. No run back here for Raymond. This will be a touchback. And Detroit getting set to go now. Right now, Charles, it just feels like they're trying to keep pace. They did score the touchdown last time out, but they still trail by double digits here. We'll see if this offense is once again up to the task.
Yeah, and I think that after the last drive, they've gotten pretty revved up, don't you think? Everything they were doing was working pretty well. They go back out there with the same mindset, play at the same tempo and the same pace. Still a lot of time left to make something happen in this one. But whenever you call and run the hitch route, a lot of times that ball's got to be in the air before the receiver even turns around. That's the result of throwing it so many times in practice. It's really a timing.
Blitz coming, and down he goes. Kenneth Murray coming in hard there on the blitz, and he gets him 7 yards behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, defensively, they're doing everything they can to protect this early lead after giving up a touchdown on their last drive.
Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Goff now to throw. A throw out wide, going to be incomplete.
Well, partner, guaranteed they approach this play with the idea of making up ground to make third down manageable. Unfortunately, with that incompletion, right back where they started on the last snap. Now they need a big third down play in order to pick up the yardage needed.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And the Chargers rush is going to get there. Down he goes. Dropped for a loss of 7 by multiple defenders.
That's 3 sacks now. That's not much of a surprise to me, nor should it be to you. This team, they lead the league in sacks.
Yeah, they do. This is something that we are starting to witness time and time again. And here now the punter, Fox, as he sends this one away. And a fair catch called for and made just inside the 35-yard line. A 40-yard punt, no return. And that will come the offense as they take over. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. They started on the ground with Eckler. He works his way forward to pick up 4 yards there, second down.
The defense thought they had that play covered, but it still got driven backward by those blockers. Those types of plays are a key part of any team's offensive game plan. It all starts up front in the trenches.
Eckler going to get it again on second down. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. But now he appears to be in some pain. More from L.A. in a moment. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Flush to his right. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run.
Well, I don't want to be a jinx partner, put the whammy on him, but I think we could be looking at all-time damn the ground with the way that he's going. Only a few quarterbacks in this league are capable of a 100-yard game, and he's halfway there just in the first quarter. This is a record-setting pace. Hopefully,
there he goes, right side. And all the way in for a Charger touchdown. Clyde Edwards aware. His third rushing touchdown of the year. And the Chargers have moved out in front by 3 touchdowns. Week after week, Charles, when we see this offense operate, I don't know, they just seem to get more impressive.
They certainly do, and let's face it, it's no surprise they're the best in the NFL in scoring. This team designs things well and executes even better. And here, it only takes a few snaps before they're in the end zone. That's how they demoralize teams. That's how they put them on notice.
Extra point up and good by Dick. The Charger drive about to get going. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up. There he goes, offside! Austin Eckler, and he takes it in for a Charger touchdown. Austin Eckler with touchdown number 23 here on the year. And the Chargers are able to widen their advantage.
I know I should keep the focus and the spotlight on the hero that just scored, but tackling's been an issue for this defense all game long. I can't set that aside. We just saw it again here. Missed tackle.
We pick it up second quarter here as the offense gets ready for the drive. They'll try and start this drive in the air, escaping the pressure right.
finds Johnston.
And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. 25 yards there on the catch and run. So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. They'll run out of the gun with Eckler. Oh, that one well designed as he'll take this down to the 30-yard line. 127 yards rushing now for the NFL leader coming into this ball game. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. He'll look to throw. And he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw, eluding the pressure right. Open man, it's Johnston. Touchdown, Chargers. 23 yards for the touchdown. And the Chargers are able to widen their lead here in this first half.
He was able to move around and found some vision to throw the football. And how about how he ended it? Boy, he had some.
The Charger drive about to get going.
Well, everything right now that they touch on this side of the football, it seems to turn to gold. They've scored on three straight possessions. That lead continues to grow. And, I mean, if they can get points here, Charles, might almost be an insurmountable comeback for the other side.
I think you make a great case for that, so I'm going to flip it over to the other side. Could they make the big comeback? Certainly. Am I expecting it? Not at all. I think if we don't see a drastic change in how they're playing, this blowout's going to get bigger and bigger before the final gun.
He'll buy some time right. And he'll even avoid the contact in the end as he will finally slide to a hole. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
Certainly not the way they drew it up in the playbook, but that's why they love this guy back there. He sees things breaking down, and he's more than capable of finding an escape route and still getting a decent gain.
Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. So they got him coming up from his linebacker spot.
And sometimes the position designation really doesn't matter. If you creep up to the line of scrimmage, you just have to look for the football. Make sure it moves before you do.
So a first and five now after the five-yard penalty from the neutral zone infraction. They'll set up to throw. And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. Give him seven on the tuck and run, and it'll give him a new set of downs.
They made a nice effort to stick him with a loss for that play, but it's going to take more than that to keep him from advancing the ball. Should be an entertaining battle anytime he tucks and runs over the second half of this contest.
Running on first down, Eckler. And he's in for a Charger touchdown. On his way to a monster game, three first-half touchdowns. And the Chargers have taken a six-touchdown lead. Now this is becoming quite the half he's had here. The Charger drive about to get going. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
Let's just call it what it is. This has been a flat-out struggle for this defense all game long. They've really had a hard time slowing them down. And while I'm not big on speeches and guys jumping up and down, they might need their team leader on defense to get in their face right now. Light a fire under these guys. They've got to start playing bit and start getting guys on the ground.
Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down. They'll look to throw, and he slings one that's incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. On third down, here's Eckler. Oh, look at the juke. Now he's into the clear again. He may go. Touchdown, Allen! Austin Eckler on his way to a historic performance. Four first half touchdowns. And the Chargers extend their lead yet again.
We see this a lot on third and short yardage, especially down here in the red zone. They're going to sell out to stop the run, try and hold them to a field goal. But once the running back...
The Charger drive about to get going. Well, this offense, this team, they are rolling right now, Charles. They've scored on three straight possessions. You look at the scoreboard, and they pretty much right now got this thing on cruise control.
Yeah, and this is that time of game where you and I have to...
This is caught inside the 15. Touchdown, Chargers. Austin Eckler, 75 yards. And the Chargers are pouring it on. And we didn't even get a chance to settle in for that drive. A quick strike of 75 yards, and they find the end zone.
Don't you get the sense that film study was behind this one, that they saw something that they thought they could take advantage of? The key.
It'll be a first and 10 coming up as this offense takes over possession of the football in the third quarter. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Over the middle, and it's caught. Keenan Allen, his second catch. This one not quite as dynamic as his first, and it's second down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
On second down, Eckler. And a solid run here as he'll pick his way down to the 42-yard line. 245 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon. So they go from one 42-yard line to the other as they come up now first and 10. Back to throw here. Steps away to his left. It won't be a sack, but it's no gain, and it brings up second down.
He certainly did his best to find something on that run, but there just wasn't enough time to make it happen. Nice effort there, avoiding the sack and getting back to the line of scrimmage. That one certainly could have ended up worse.
Shifts by him, and he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. And it appears we have a Charger shaken up on that last play. More from L.A. in a moment. So first and 10 now from the 30. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. He's got his man. That's Everett, the tight end. Touchdown. Gerald Everett, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Chargers have got it on cruise control. Boy, another score. This lead gets even bigger. And Charles, we haven't even hit the fourth quarter yet.
Well, forget the deficit, right? They're really not going to cut into that heck.
The Charger drive about to get going. Well, they don't really need the points here, Charles, given what we're looking at on the scoreboard, but they've scored on three consecutive possessions, three consecutive drives, and I'm sure that they would like to keep that streak going here and continuing to pour it on.
And things have gotten that way in the NFL, haven't they, partner? Because in the old days, people would, you know, they'd get off the gas a little bit, right? But now, people continue to accelerate. But we'll see what they decide to do as they come out for this one. But the way that this game has gone, they've got to be awfully happy with their execution overall.
Eckler going to get it again on second down. Up past the 25 to the 26, a gain of five. Here is third down and four. It's Eckler again. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. A gain there of 12 yards and a first down, LA.
And carries like that, that's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball. Keep the.
It's caught inside the 25. And he's going to be out of bounds all the way down inside the 15. A big play there for LA. 51 yards.
And even with the game seemingly in hand, they're continuing to fire away, pressing the ball down the field. Listen, it's worked all day. No reason to go away from it now.
A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. Out of the gun, Eckler running it. And he takes it in for a Charger touchdown. Austin Eckler taking it in from 11 yards out. And the Chargers add on to their lead, and it's looking like that win streak is going to extend another week. So how about the season, Charles, if he continues to put together? That's now two. The Charger drive about to get going. And they just continue to roll right along, really. This has the looks of yet another victory as they hope to polish it off here in quarter number four. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He get three.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. Up the middle with Eckler. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. A gain of 4 that time as the drive continues.
Brandon, when a defense just simply can't get off the field on third down, and we all know how important that down is for both sides of the ball, you often feel like you're just a step behind whatever they're doing offensively.
And one of the differences in this game, no doubt, third down conversion, and that is going to be a story they'll talk about after this one. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple. On the give, this is Eckler. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That good for 19 and a first down. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Going deep here for Allen. And this is caught. And he's going to be out of bounds all the way down at the 2. So close. A big play there for LA. 44 yards. And they'll let the fullback try and take him home. And this will result in him losing yardage. Back to the 3. It's a loss of a yard there. And now second down. They'll set up a throw to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Their passing attack, even though that one was incomplete, has been really sharp in this one. It's resulted in a lot of touchdowns, and it looks like they're not going to stop throwing the football until the very end of this one.
Well, that will certainly make everyone involved on offense pretty happy because that gives them all a chance. The Panthers.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Los Angeles. Late stages of the game here in the fourth quarter as his offense takes over first and 10. They'll start on the ground here on first down.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
So fourth quarter, a nice run there to start this drive. Charles, what do you think the split will be here between run and pass?
Well, partner, I think it'll lean towards the run, but this is also not a time where you just totally do that. You still have to possess the ball, move the sticks, and keep the clock moving as well. So they'll run their offense, but yeah, when they have a chance to run it, they'll do that a little bit more.
And from the 34, here's second and four.
Once more, here's Eckler. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. A loss on that play, and now third down gets tougher. Third and six. On this day, the ground has been his, but at least on that individual play, we just saw the defense finally with a win.
Yeah, they finally got one, and that's a win for them, but all game long, he's seen the holes, and they've been huge for him. Kind of like a baseball hitter in the zone. The ball seems bigger. And he's just whacking it. These guys, they've got it going today.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. And under the Lions' pressure, he's brought down.
Levi Onwuzurike charging in and finishing off the sack.
Here's J.K. Scott now. Always a good sign when your first punt comes in the fourth quarter. This is taken at the 23. It's a return of four following a 42-yard punt, and the Lions will take over.
Detroit's offense ready to take over. They were coming off the extra week of rest, but this team started slugging.
First down.
A little short pass here taken in by Laporta.
They'll wind up getting seven on the play, and that'll make it second down. That's a staple of this offense, drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
Goff on third down.
Oh, he tried to fit it in on the slant, and it's intercepted.
Picked up by J.C. Jackson, and his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. Yet another mistake after the interception there. Gosh, you look up at the scoreboard, they just got to be thinking this one cannot get over fast enough.
It certainly can't. And also what happens when you get this big of a deficit, you're supposed to make all the right throws, right? You're supposed to try and obviously get the ball to your own guys. But being down this big, you also take even more chances. And in this situation, that hasn't paid off for them at all.
On the other sideline, jubilation and laughter.
Jack Campbell, a first-round pick there on the tackle. They'll work from the 36 on second and six.
A handoff, it's Eckler. Call it a gain of a yard, and it's going to bring up third and five.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game, and while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
The Chargers on third down, they have been superb. 5 for 6 to this point. This will be third and five. Now Eckler. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. They get six on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with, and throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to, and it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
Going on the ground with Eckler. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Oh, that was a thing of beauty right there. Look at how quick those blockers fired off the line once the ball was snapped. That was an O-line on a mission, all in sync, and the defense is lucky that play only picked up 5 yards.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Charger football as we welcome you back from the two-minute warning. They've got a second down now as they look to salt this one away. They'll run here with Eckler. 7 yards there and a first down. No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score.
And they will take a knee here. And they'll indeed take a knee. It was truly playing at an elite level in this contest.
Partner, this game was over a long time ago, and you noticed they did not want to slow down anything. Absolutely a dream scenario for everyone on that offense, and they took advantage of every second. Guaranteed popcorn for everyone in their film session.
So for the Chargers, the train just keeps rolling. 9-0 now to start this campaign. That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. With that, we say so long from Southern California. Thank you.